My name is Tyler Kerr. I am the Makerspace Coordinator for the Engineering Education and Research Building Student Innovation Center for the biggest makerspace here at the University of Wyoming.
And I'm Lars Koltoff. I'm an Assistant Professor of Computer Science. I work in the same building as Tyler, and I am actually physically in the makerspace as well. However, we are certainly more than 6 feet apart at the moment. I do a little bit of research related to advanced manufacturing, but I mostly pursue 3D printing as a hobby, and this is how I got involved in this.
We actually got a phone call from the Cheyenne Regional Medical Center, and they had requested that we start to 3D print some face masks as well as some face shields. And so one of the things we started to do was 3D print these face masks and face shields in order to meet the demand. So we're currently 3D printing 100 face masks and 100 face shields for the Cheyenne Regional Medical Center. Right now, we are actually paying for all of the different materials to produce this out of our pocket. So one of the things that was really important to us is to make sure that the hospital communities had as few burdens from us as possible. And so we really wanted to make sure that the materials and labor we were providing in order to get these face masks and face shields into the hands of the hospital in Cheyenne, as well as other hospitals in the community, we wanted to make sure it was free.
One of the first designs that we had a look at and that we 3D printed is this one that I'm trying to show here. This is a relatively simple piece that prints very quickly and that you then fold to fit your face. We very quickly discovered that this does not work at all. You can maybe see it. It's kind of cracked. There's all kinds of holes. The surface is very rough. It is very difficult to fit to your face. It doesn't really seal it tightly. So we found that this particular design was not really usable at all in practice.
And so one of the things that is a key distinction that's sort of important to highlight here is the fact that we are printing surgical masks. And we are not 3D printing surgical, or rather face respirators. And so one of the key distinctions here are surgical masks are just sort of a barrier between your face, so your nose and your mouth, and outside droplets. So if somebody's sneezing or coughing, they can do so into their own mask. And then if they're wearing a mask and someone else is sneezing and coughing, they wouldn't have any of that droplet particulate enter their system. So all we're doing is creating these surgical masks to provide a barrier from droplets. This is an example of an N95 respirator, and this is something we are not printing. To have a respirator, you have to go through a number of different channels. The FDA has to run this through trials and make sure that it is effectively filtering out, in the case of an N95, 95% of airborne particulate. It has to be fit tested to your face. So you have to go through pretty rigorous fit tests to make sure that this is the mask and the right size mask for you. You can see my beard means that I can't even wear these because there won't be a tight seal to my face. So one of the things we're really trying to steer people away from is 3D printing respirators. The hospitals right now have asked for face masks. And so those surgical masks are what we're 3D printing right now. And so this is an example of a 3D printed surgical mask. And so you'll see that there's a filter here. And one of the things that this does is really just protect my nose and my mouth from getting outside droplets coming in. And if I cough and sneeze, preventing that from getting out. So that's the key distinction that we're doing. We're also 3D printing face shields. So Cheyenne Regional Hospital has asked us to create these. And so we will be laser cutting the visor itself and then 3D printing the housing and the headband. So that's what we're creating right now in the Student Innovation Center.
Although this is what we're focusing at the moment, there is no tooling that is set up specifically for this, which is one of the big advantages of 3D printing. So if something else became relevant later on, we can very easily switch to that.
The really wonderful thing is all of us together are trying to, and we will actually be 3D printing over the next 48 hours. We're taking shifts. We have a morning shift, we have an afternoon shift, we also have an evening shift. So we're coming in small shifts to make sure that the printers are running smoothly, but also importantly to make sure that these printers are there's no downtime between the printers, that they're all printing pretty much continuously.
just actually started printing the day today because we just got our special filament in. And if you take a look here, you'll see that that's one of our Ultimakers, and it's just laying down the foundation, that first layer, before it builds and masses up. And all we do is heat up that plastic with one of our extruders and melt it and extrude it out onto the build plate to 3D print apart layer by layer. So all of these are gonna be built like this. So you'll see on our biggest 3D printers here, they're printing three masks all at once in the same printer. And on our smaller printers, they're going with two masks. And so what we found is we can produce about two masks every 8 hours between the machines. So by our math, we're looking at about 48 masks that we can print in a 24-hour period. So what we're hoping is that Cheyenne Regional Medical Center has asked for 100 of these by next Monday. And so we're gonna hit that deadline, but it's all because, and all credit is goes to these guys and the hard work that they're doing. So they've given up their weekends, they're willing to work here, and they're willing to work with this people to make sure that we get this protective equipment over to Cheyenne Regional Medical Center as soon as And so one of the things we're also gonna be doing is laser cutting, using our two laser cutters here. We're gonna be cutting out those face shields out of a PPG material that we can then fasten to the 3D printing parts. So we have laser cutters that'll be working here in just a second that will be able to cut out parts. And if we open this guy up, you can see that we did cut out a mask earlier today just as a quick little test run. And that mask was what we showed you earlier, that face shield. And then this room is sort of quiet right now because we're just in the staging process and we're getting started with some of our planning. One of the things that this room will be taken over by are community donated and loaned printers. So I think we're super lucky that we have this incredible community in front of us. And to date, we have 13 3D printers loaned out to us from everybody from IT here at the university to our sister space, the Co Student Innovation Center in the library, theater and dance, LCCC, all sorts of community groups have come in and lent us their printers. So we can essentially up our production and get things into the hands of these hospitals fast.
One of the groups we've been coordinating with is the Wyoming Technology Coronavirus Coalition, which was founded by Eric Trowbridge about 10 days ago, I think it was now, on March 17th, so just before the order came from the governor that we need to be really careful about this, shut some public places, etc. And this has been a great success so far. So we have seen, we have grown to over 100 volunteers now and working on everything from things like this, things like you've seen just now, 3D printing parts for hospitals, but also looking at what else is required. Because for example, a lot of people are out of work. How can we help those people? We are also looking at things like organizing medical supply drives. By the way, there's going to be one on April 1st, Wednesday next week, here at UW from 12 noon to 4 p.m. So if you have any spare medical supplies and unopened boxes, come by and donate them because we will be needing them.
So one of the things that would really, really help us right now are donations of either 3D printers that you'll temporarily loan us that we can help put to this effort and start 3D printing parts. If you're willing to do so here, that would be wonderful. If you'd like to keep it at home, we have a couple protocols in place that we can share with you to make sure you're doing so safely. And the other thing that would be really, really helpful to us is more filament. One thing I mentioned earlier is that we are just buying this stuff out of pocket right now. If anyone has spare filament lying around or knows of where to get additional filament, please do contact us. And likewise, maybe just lend a hand and help us out.
And more generally, if you're interested in helping, you can join the Wyoming Technology Coronavirus Coalition. We have a Slack channel. Well, we have about a dozen Slack channels right now based around various things. One of the newer ones is one for people who know how to sew, because we've been starting to look at how to sew medical masks and gowns. This is still in the early stages, but you can join even if you know nothing about 3D printing, even if you know nothing about tech, if you have organizational skills, if you know other people who might be able to help. And we have a website where you can find more information. You can find the URL at the bottom of the screen. And of course, also contact each one of us. Both Tyler and I would be happy to point you to further resources if you're interested in this.
So that's all we have today. Lars and I will both be on later today on Instagram stories to answer some questions that you guys might have. But thank you for joining us today for Cowboy Coffee.